Welcome to a second video on solving one-step equations. In this video, we'll take a look at equations involving fractions. Since we already discussed the basic principles on solving one-step equations in the previous video, we're going to go ahead and take a look at our additional examples right away. So on this first problem, we have x minus 1/2 is equal to 1/4. Remember, the ultimate goal of a linear equation is to isolate the variable. So if we want just x, not x minus 1/2, we'll have to undo this minus 1/2. Well, the opposite of minus 1/2 would be plus 1/2. So we're going to have to add 1/2 to both sides of this equation. Let's go ahead and rewrite it in that form. We're going to have x minus 1/2, and then we're going to add 1/2 equals 1/4 plus 1/2. Notice on the left side, minus 1/2 plus 1/2, that's going to be 0. So we're left with x on the left. And now on the right side, we do have to obtain a common denominator. The least common denominator is going to be 4. So we'll multiply 1/2 by 2 over 2. So that's going to give us 1/4 plus, this will be 2/4. So the result would be 3/4. X is equal to 3/4. Number 2 is very similar. We want to isolate the x, but right now we have x plus 3/4. Well, the opposite of plus 3/4 will be minus 3/4. So we're going to have to subtract 3/4 on both sides of the equation. So we'll have x plus 3/4 minus 3/4 equals 4/5 minus 3/4. Again, notice on the left side, plus 3/4 minus 3/4, that would be 0. So we're left with x on the left. And then notice on the right side, we do have to obtain a common denominator again. The least common denominator of 5 and 4 would be 20. So we'll have to multiply 4/5 by 4 over 4. We'll have to multiply 3/4 by 5 over 5. So here we're left with 16/20 plus 15/20. That'll give us 31/20. This doesn't simplify, but it is an improper fraction, so we may have to convert this to a mixed number. Let's go ahead and do that. Remember, the process for that would be to take 31 and divide it by 20. Well, 20 goes into 31 one time. We subtract the remainder of 11. So this is equivalent to 1 11/20. Now let's solve a couple using the multiplication principle. Here we have 2/3 x equals 4/21. Well, this is attached by multiplication. Again, to isolate x, we want to undo this multiplication here. We have 2/3 times x. Well, the opposite of multiplication is division. So we could divide both sides by 2/3. We normally don't divide with fractions. We multiply by the reciprocal. So we're going to multiply both sides of this equation by the reciprocal of 2/3, or 3/2. Again, the reason why you multiply by the reciprocal is, notice we have 3 over 3, that's 1, and 2 over 2, that's 1. So we're left with x on the left side by itself, or isolated. And now on the right side, we have to perform this multiplication here. We can simplify this. It's a common factor of 2 here. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 2 2's and 4. There's a common factor of 3 here. There's 1, 3, and 3, and 7 3's and 21. Now we multiply across the top. We'll have 2. Multiply across the bottom. We'll have 7. X equals 2/7. On number 2, we have 5y equals 10/13. So remember that 5y means 5 times y. So to undo this multiplication here, we want to divide by 5. But notice that we have a fraction over here. So if we have a fraction over here, instead of dividing by 5, we should probably multiply by the reciprocal. Remember that 5 is the same as 5 over 1. So if we multiply both sides by the reciprocal, it would be 1 over 5. So multiply both sides by 1/5. Again, the reason we're doing this instead of dividing by 5 is because the right side is in fraction form. Dividing by 5 and multiplying by 1/5 is equivalent. The 5's simplify out. We're left with 1y or y. And on the right side, we just need to multiply these fractions together, but we can simplify here. The common factor of 5 here, so this simplifies to 1, this simplifies to 2. We have y equals 2 over 13, or 2/13. Now we're going to mix in some negatives. Here we have negative 2/7 x equals 4/5. So again, this is connected by multiplication. The opposite of multiplication is division. So instead of dividing by negative 2/7, we're going to multiply by the reciprocal. The reciprocal would be negative 7 over 2. Do the same on both sides. Again, this simplifies nicely to 1x or x. And on the right side, this simplifies here. This simplifies to 1, this simplifies to 2. Looks like we're going to have negative 14 over 5. Again, that doesn't simplify, but that is an improper fraction. So to convert this to a mixed number, we know the result will be negative, so now we'll just take 14 and divide by 5. 5 goes into 14 two times, that'd be 10. Subtract, we have a remainder of 4. So the equivalent mixed number would be negative 2 and 4/5. Okay, I think we'll stop here for this video. I hope you found these examples helpful.